first queen to get a Brazilian?
Oh, Cleopatra.
Why do you think her?
She used to bath in milk. She was up for stuff.
Ass's milk?
Yeah, not even normal milk.
No.
She married several of her brothers. She was a, you know, what we'd call now a weirdo.
No, it is not
so
her.
Get a Brazilian husband?
We are heading indeed to Brazil, if that helps. I had to have this picture explained to me when I first saw it.
Well, we know more about you than we thought we did. I'm in the same gang as you.
Hi. Oh, girl. Honestly, I thought it was caramel. I had no idea. We're going to 1807. We are going to Portugal. The Crown Prince, Dom João. Napoleon is approaching, and he takes his entire court, including his queen, Carlotta, and he thinks, let's go to one of our colonies, and they head off to Brazil. So they go off in a convoy of ships from Lisbon to Brazil. 10,000 people go with him, and it's unbelievably overcrowded and unhygienic, and a lice infestation breaks out. So, in order to get rid of the lice, they all, including all the women, they have to shave their heads, they have to throw all their powdered wigs away and cover their heads in pig fat. Now, they're about to arrive in Brazil. They want to make a bit of a stir.
But to do.
But they've got bald heads and pig fat.
I think that'll do the job there.
They arrive at a place called Guanabara Bay, and Carlotta and all the other royal women emerged with their bald heads covered with improvised turbans. And apparently, so the story goes, the Brazilian women thought this was the height of European style, and it became the local fashion. The problem is that Brazil is full of a wonderful African-Brazilian population, and I would have thought that the turban thing would have come from that part of the world originally, but we don't know.
So they were bald everywhere, then?
Are you worrying about...
I've just grown me winter's coat in.
This one looks not unlike David Mitchell.
Do you not think she looks a bit like Marty Feldman?
Yes, crossed with this... David Mitchell.
This is building up into quite the compliment.
Whether the story is true or not about the Brazilians, there is a long history of commoners imitating royals. There was a man called Guillermo, Duke of Mantua. He was a hunchback, so we're talking 16th century. And so all of his courtiers put humps on to compliment him.
Aww. You've got to judge that carefully.
Yeah.
It might look like you're taking the piss.
Just a bit. Here's another interesting fashion for royals. Louis XIV, he had a fashion that a courtier should have one long fingernail. Why was that?
My husband's got one special toenail for scratching his eczema. It's awful, isn't it? Is that the sort of thing you're after?
I feel in this show you and I are in danger of oversharing.
And you seem to be fine with that, though. That's...
Yeah, as long as he keeps it to himself, I'm all right.
Right.
Yeah.
He hasn't really, has he, now?
No.
He told me quite recently, and we've been together for nearly 15 years. So there's nothing I can do about it now, is what I'm saying. Yeah. I'm stuck with it.
Except maybe pay more attention in the future. Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.